that put an end to the whole narrative. What one has been made to believe up to now is that the SARS-CoV-2 virus is so new that our immune system will not recognize it, and therefore, when the need arises, the immune system will not respond in time with the production of antibodies that they could save our lives. And that's why we need to be vaccinated. That's why the whole world needs to be vaccinated. Now, scientific publications that have appeared in the last weeks, as I said, put an end to this narrative, because it turns out that the corona SARS-CoV-2 virus and its descendants are not so different from the old normal coronaviruses that it would not be recognized by the immune system. Now, I'll try to explain this with this chart here. This is the immune system. And the immune system can make many components. One of them are the antibodies that the immune system will make when it meets a new opponent, a virus. Now, depending on whether the immune system recalls that it has seen this virus before or not, the response will be slow. A first response is always slow, takes about 4 weeks for the antibodies to be made, and these antibodies are called IgM, immune globulin M. If, however, the immune system has seen this virus before and remembers it, because the immune system has a memory, then it quickly makes other antibodies, which are called IgG and IgA. These are recall antibodies. Now, these antibodies serve principally two functions. One function is that if it's a virus that the antibodies are supposed to combat, the antibodies can try to prevent the entry of the virus into your cell. This is what the antibodies to corona are supposed to do. They are called protective antibodies because they protect the cell from getting infected by the virus. If, however, the cell does get infected, then lymphocytes are there behind the scenes that will come out and recognize that the cell is infected, and these killer lymphocytes have their duty to kill the cell. So once the cell is killed, the virus factory is destroyed, the virus can't be produced anymore, and you get up and go back to work. The other function of antibodies, major function, is that if the antibodies are directed against a bacterium or a fungal, then these antibodies will bind to the bacteria, and that will cause another arm of the immune system to be activated. This is so-called complement, because it complements the action of the antibodies, and leukocytes. Leukocytes are the cells that eat. These are cells that are in your blood, and they're circulating all the time, and they're waiting for these bacteria to come into your blood, be coated with the antibodies, and then they will come and eat them. And thus are you protected by your antibodies against bacteria. So we have actually two major arms of the immune system. One are the lymphocytes that are directed against viruses and virus-infected cells, and the others are leukocytes that are directed against bacteria. It's like the Navy and the Air Force. Air Force, Navy. And both are really deadly. They take care of all the viruses that you are confronted with and all the bacteria normally. So, the question is now, is our immune system really blind to the new, so-called new SARS-CoV-2 virus question? Now, this can be answered very simply. And that, for that, what one has to do is, one has to inject this virus or the virus gene into the body and see how long the immune system takes to make the antibodies against this gene. And this was done by three independent American research groups in the last weeks and published. So everyone can go and have a look at these papers, and everyone should look at the papers, because two questions arise. First, was the antibody response fast or slow? This would be fast, and this would be slow. 30 days, 10 days, or 5 days. And if it were fast, did the antibodies carry the correct label, IgG, IgA, or the wrong label? So, what do you think? I'm going to ask you. The Americans measured in the blood the appearance of the antibodies every day. The people who are telling you that you should get vaccinated are going to say, of course, they were IgM antibodies because this was blind to them. But the fact is the opposite. All groups found out that everyone who had been vaccinated responded with IgG and IgA antibodies within days after the vaccination, which is absolute proof that it is a recall response to something that the immune system has recognized. You may ask me, how can this be? The answer is very simple. Look, this is the hand, the grasping hand of the virus. This is the spike. And the spike is there to grasp the handle of the door to your cell to get in. The antibody comes and forces itself into the jaw like the crocodile. The mouth is open. It stops the crocodile from closing its mouth. Of course, this is not completely correct, but it will do as a picture for you, all right? Now, this